You just want to get out of here. And you likely don't want to tag along like me. It's just, Mr. Thompson has his own view on matters, on account of it's his job and what all, but that's not the only side of the tale.
I wanted you with me. This is about the deserters? So what's the other side of it?
To Mr. Thompson, a person's a gear. It does its job quiet-like. If it squeaks or stutters, it gets replaced. The deserters are decent folk. I knew some of them before they left.
I can't blame anybody for wanting to leave. This town's got some issues.
Life's hard here. Especially for them that don't fit in so well. We're one big Spacer's Choice family, but every family's got the one the rest whisper about. Mr. Thompson's aiming to take away their power. They'll have no lights to see, nor heat to cook. They'll be at the mercy of marauders, or worse. I think you should talk to the town's vicar about it. Max, his name is.
Yeah, talk to him. I met the vicar. He asked me to find a book for him.
Books are for rich folk. I wonder what he wants with something like that.
I suppose it couldn't hurt. We'll stop by.
Thanks, ma'am. I just think when you gotta make a decision that'll hurt somebody, it's best to think on the right and wrong of it. That's what my dad used to say anyways.
No, don't worry. I'm not gonna take their power away unless there's absolutely no other option.
Something you need?
That's barred. I wonder if it could be in there. There's another door on that side. But there's stairs here, so how would we get in there? Coming up. For some reason, I just wanted to see her come up the ladder. I don't know why.
Some bullheads running around town talking about lost colony ships.
Yeah, I haven't been over here. Close the door. Hoping we'll find the book in here. Guess not. Terminal access foreman, Phyllis Granger. Messages. Welcome, Phyllis Granger from R. Tobson. Medical treatment. Phyllis, owing to your hard work and positive attitude, I have sanctioned your access to medical treatment in the event of contagion. As you know, the company has not provided us with enough medicine to treat every worker. I wish I could treat every member of the Spacer's Choice family who fell ill to this plague, but I cannot. Medical privileges are strictly merit-based. Please do not, under any circumstance, distribute a ration of medication to any other worker. We're all in this together. Personal files. Bypass. Hack 5. Hack used. Password Tenderfoot. Alright, continue. Personal files. Last entry. Theodore Berry last night. Reed asked me not to report his death in our quarterlies. Sounds fair to me. Was asked to prepare a statement or something for the other workers. Been thinking about it. Don't know what to tell them. Don't end up like Theodore. Do your work, show up, wear a smile, or you'll get medical... and you'll get medical privileges. It's a start. I thought we were gonna find that book here. Damn it. Oh. So I didn't pick up everything.
You the new worker?
Whatever. Oh.
Make it quick, Tenderfoot. I'm busy.
I just look through your logs. I'm guessing you're the foreman.
Foreman Granger. Mind those words don't come out of your mouth unless preceded by yes or right away or thank you.
Whatever. A gravesite fees. I'm here to collect.
Shit. Silas still on about that? Here, take the fees. I'd appreciate it if you didn't tell Reed I was late on my payment.
Hey, these papers aren't signed in your name.
Because they're not my fees and not my gravesite. Guy I worked with shot himself. I paid the bill.
You have to pay for your neighbor's gravesite fees?
If you're not familiar with board law, you ought to be. Law requires delinquent gravesite fees to be paid by the deceased party's closest living relative, which meant me. Hmm. Shame, though. Eugene was a good worker.
Because he had no actual relative, so you're the neighbor? This guy shot himself?
Woke up one morning and put a round through his upper story. Can't imagine why. The kid was doing all right at his desk. We all thought he was an upstanding receptionist. Just between the two of us, I'm pretty shocked his weapon didn't misfire. Spacer's Choice handguns aren't the most reliable.
That's an awful thing to say.
Not half as awful as the bill Eugene left us with. Suicide's a crime. The legal term is irreparable damage to company property. What Eugene did to himself was vandalism.
What are they gonna do? Arrest his corpse?
When one of your workers commits a crime, the entire town pays for it. In other words, Edgewater would have been penalized pretty hard. Whatever Eugene was worth as an asset, we would have had to pay out of pocket to Spacer's Choice.
What if? You didn't?
Look around. Edgewater ain't exactly swimming in luxury. We can't afford to pay the body price of a suicide. All I know is Silas asked me for Eugene's gravesite fees, which means he was approved for burial, which means his papers went through, which means the town's in the clear. I'm just glad to put this whole ugly affair behind me. Eugene can rest his bones in peace, and the rest of us can get on with our own lives.
Hmm.
Somebody's been spinning a tale about a lost colony ship. Talk like that'll get you reported real quick.
I'd like to talk to you about Eugene.
I paid his burial fees, didn't I? Let the dead sleep.
Alright, actually, never mind then. I'm looking for this book.
You're safer inside the walls.
Alright, well, I got it. I'm within quite a few walls here. Come on in. There it is! Hey, lady. Come in. You okay out there? Oh, I just see her name. I just noticed her name underneath. on the left side, underneath the hit points and all that fun stuff. A bypass shunt. Got it. We found the second volume. Is it not his volume? I don't think it is. So volume 1, they're both dense technical primers on mechanical engineering published by Spacer's Choice. Volume 1 describes the process of building a computing machine using electrodes and spectrum potatoes. And volume 2 describes the process of repairing and dismantling common models of auto-mechanical workers. Fun Times Barrel? The special rifled barrel fits. Let's a ranged weapon shoot a little more precisely, making critical hits do more damage. Huh. That's cool. Mr. Power. Attaches to a melee weapon and makes it emit pure plasma. Sweet. 20 bits. What'd she say? Okay, I got a revolver, light ammo, heavy armor, 11 bits, and an algae logger. Tunnel access, company notifications. From the office of Reed Thompson, Outpost Administrator. Symptoms of infection have now reached a critical mass. I've instructed our staff to transform the old domicile into a sick house. Plague is a reality of life on the frontier, and as spacers, we're expected to face up to reality. And the reality is that we do not carry enough medicine to treat all of you. Medical treatment is a privilege, not a right. We must strive every day to demonstrate our worthiness of that privilege. If you find yourself suffering the symptoms of incipient plague, the best thing you could do for yourself and for your family is to don your jumpers and come to work. Work fortifies the spirit. Physical illness recapitulates spiritual weakness. That's really stupid, because number one, you're just going to make yourself more sick. Number two, you're going to be spreading it to other workers. Idiots. Anything else around here? Alright, 2 out of 3 volumes. Know where the other one would happen to be. It doesn't look like there's anyone around here. So I got another mag pick. I don't see anyone around. So far, so good. Little extra bits and some goodies. I like goodies. So wait. Well, I got more codex. Hold on. Companion wants to talk. Occasionally, companions may have something on their mind. When you see a thought bubble, dot, 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 above their head, try talking to them. They may have something interesting to say. I thought I already looked at that. So wait. Region. But I can't switch back. Oh, yeah. So the landing pad is southeast. Can I? It makes sense to just walk over there. I can tell him we killed the robot. Oh wait! Abernathy! Before I leave, Abernathy. Oh, we also need to talk to the guy again. The pastor.
Rations yet?
Whatever his name is.
2 whole cans of salt tuna.
Guys don't eat anything else.
Oh, I cut my own hair. But Conrad sells real good disinfectant. Something you need?
Oh, she's just commenting on because I'm by the barber.
I don't want any trouble.
Alright. Wasn't planning on giving you any trouble. So someone else was killing these sprats. I just kind of ignored them because they weren't doing anything to me.
Heard something outside the walls.
Alright, so that's that. Returning to pastor, and then
friend of mine died a couple weeks back. Still ain't past it.
Nothing I can do about that.
Abernathy, where is he again? Here he is.
Whoa, did Mr. Thompson send you? Well, you tell Mr. Thompson I'll be right at my post tomorrow. Bright and early tomorrow, because I'm definitely not plagued. As spry as a spring chicken. That's old Abernathy.
You want to tell me what's got you so nervous?
You some sort of wandering alienist? Walking into a man's own domicile, pestering him about his mental state?
Well, anyway, you're Martin Abernathy?
What? No. I mean, I might be. That depends on who's asking.
I'm not looking for trouble. I'm just here to collect your gravesite fees.
Silas knows, doesn't he? That's why he sent you. That's why he wants me to pay up. He knows.
Knows what?
I'm dying. I'm not long for this world. The date of my expiration is fast approaching. And soon I shall be ushered through the great cannery in the skies.
Don't say that, Mr. Abernathy. You still got a couple decades in you?
I'd steer clear, Ms. Holcomb. My affliction's bound to be contagious. It's plague. Has to be. Silas knows. He knows I got one foot in my grave, and now he wants to charge me for the other one.
Sorry to hear that.
You are? Oh, wow. First time anyone's ever told me that. I'll pay your fees.
Sweet.
I don't want any trouble from Silas. But if you could see a way to freelancing for me, I could really use the help.
Why do you think I'm a freelancer?
Oh, hey, I'm sorry. I didn't mean nothing by it. Wasn't trying to insult you.
Why would I be insulted? I have a lot of questions.
Was just you ain't one of us. A spacer, I mean. Stands to reason you got no company looking after you. Not your fault, though. Even freelancers gotta eat. And if that means they must scratch some bits out of odd jobs, who am I to judge them? At least you're not a deserter.
What kind of odd job are you referring to?
Couple hours out of your day and some light second story work, that's all. There's a cache of anthracillin tucked away in the old community center. Powerful stuff. Stronger than what we got, anyway. I need you to break in, nab that medicine, and bring it back to me.
Reputation crease. Well, I already turned it in to the constable. Sorry, Abernathy, I gave that anthracillin to someone else.
You what? But why? I was dependent on you.
I didn't know.
Does it feel good? Robbing an old man of his last shred of hope?
A little bit, yeah.
You really are a piece of work. I hope somebody with plague spits in your drink.
What?
So, you just here to watch me die, or what?
I already gave it to somebody before I even knew you well, I knew you existed, but I didn't know you were sick. Love it. Every time I level up, I do feel bad, though. Your companion has leveled up and can be granted a new perk. Go to the companion page in the ledger. Select the perk button to see available perks. Okay, so I leveled up. Skill points available. Yeah, I'm losing this because I have retrofitted heavy power armor. Sounds familiar, huh? Like Fallout. Heavy weapons. Let's get my medical up. Oh, I can't do that. Wait. There we go. There we go. Parvati. Accept. The companion ledger shows you everything you need to know about your companions. You can see their skills, stats, status effects, and gear. To change your companion's gear, first select the item you want to swap out, then choose a compatible item to replace it with. You can also change how they behave in combat by selecting their preferred weapon, follow distance, and aggressiveness. Okay, so she's got perks. Increase your engineering skill. No, notice this is circle, I guess, because she's like really good at this engineering. And engineering. Decrease the amount of threat this companion generates when attacking enemies. Making them... Okay, so she's less likely to be attacked. Boisterous. More likely to attack this companion. Why can't I just increase her health? Let's make her sneaky, so I don't want her to die. Marked for purchase. And she doesn't look like a tank character, so... I mean, I could be wrong. Alright, so... apply. Okay. Stay close to the player, follow at a moderate distance, or follow from a distance. Just hope she doesn't get in the way of me. Mixed, I guess, good. Aggressive. The companion always engages in attacks when the player enters combat. So does it have any status effects? She has 8 armor. So now she's always going to have this on, so you know what I'm going to do? This is kind of unrealistically, but... Timed fade. Okay. Area names. Okay. Fix that. That was bothering me when I talked to people that just always said Edgewater. Above their heads or on their heads. Show player helmet. Oh, wait, companion helmets. Yeah, I think I'm gonna turn mine off too. Okay. Well, I didn't know that would make him so upset with us. I didn't have a way to tell him that, yeah, I met the constable first and gave her the medicine.
Friend of mine died a couple weeks back. Still ain't past it.
We should keep our voices down.
Oh, I got codex. Tell me about perks. Did I undo what I did? I must have undid it. I don't know if that's how I had it, but... Yeah, I didn't go apply. Except. Alright. I don't know if that's what I had it at. Let's better. You can actually see me in the menus. That's good. Otherwise, you'll never see my face. Speak to the vicar. Can't afford to pay his fees. Otherwise, we're done with that quest. Talk to the vicar. The Vava Vicar. Is there a name for this place?
I've always felt weird in here. It's too clean.
You think so?
Work fortifies the spirit.
Hello once again.
Any progress on that matter we discussed? Ah, Miss Holcomb. How rare to see you out. And with a complete stranger. Curious.